Battery is connected to 6 resistors. Potential difference for 5 of them are given already. What's the potential difference across R? This is like a puzzle, man. We have a lot of unknowns. So what I will do first is I'm going to choose this first loop. Kirchhoff's loop. I need some EMF because I have all these potential drop. I mean, current is flowing like this, lah. So I need to add together, lor. 12. Okay, so let's say EMF is going to be, this is Kirchhoff's law, all the sum of potential drop in the loop. So EMF, there's only one battery, will be 1.2 plus 4.1 plus 3.7, giving me a value of, I think 9 volts. Yeah, 9 volts. So this is going to be 9 volts. Very good, first clue. You know why I find the clue? Because then I want to find the second loop. So I do another time. Oh, this time we loop here. Okay, loop number 2. Sum of EMF equals the sum of potential drop. Yeah, in parallel, so you still get 9 volts. But now you have 3 resistors. So 2.2 drop. It's one drop here. 1.2 N. What's this R? Don't know. I just say the potential drop across R lah. Okay. So here we will find the potential drop of R as 4.4 volts. That's the second loop. So let's looks like we have our answer. Best choice, 4.4. And that is the second loop with current flowing this way. From high to low potential. There is a third loop you could draw, which is shorter, but is very dangerous if you don't look carefully. This is the pink loop. You say, Miss, can't I just do this? Can't you draw this loop and just find everything? Can? You gotta be careful. So, or alternatively, let's say I start in this corner and I move down. There's no EMF here, so it's all just potential drop only. Okay, so this method, the easier way to do this is to say, in the loop, there's no battery. So how? So all the potential change in the loop should be zero. No drop rise, you must include everything. So the first one, if I go down across this, is a drop. So I say, okay, minus 2.2. Then I go down this way. It's a drop again. Okay, so minus 1.2. Why I write the V? No need to write V. Next one. I'm still following current from high to low. So this is also a drop. Minus VR. Okay, then I come down here. Nothing. Okay, now this is where it gets a bit tricky. If I go up this way, I am going against the current flow, you know. You see the current? The blue color arrow? This is current. Current flows from high potential to low potential. And if I'm going up, I'm going uphill actually, up the mountain. See the water is going down, I go up the mountain. So this is a rise if I want to go in that direction. 3.7. The last one, if I'm going in this direction, the pink arrow, there's also a rise, 4.1. And I come back to the same spot, so I should be at the same potential. If we rearrange this, then we're like, it will be something like this, or 3.7 plus 4.1 equals to 2.2 plus 1.2 plus VR. Doesn't that look familiar, kind of? So if you use this method, you should get VR also 4.4. But the tricky thing is, if you choose this loop, you need to know your positive, negative, and get them correctly. So not recommended to use this form. Use the other form of Kirchhoff's second law, where you don't assume it's EMF and drop. It's just, could be rise, could be drop. You see carefully, lo, how you move in the circuit. Okay? So that's how we can look at this question. Alright. Next.